Guy, Sharyn, and Clint podcast. I like it.
Hello, everybody, and welcome along to the Guy, Sharyn, and Clint podcast.
Welcome to the podcast, the most magical place in the world.
Welcome.
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 It's been a big show today.
Chang.
Today on the show, we went into the Love Shack. We found out what happened on the shark bus. And our old mate Chang today found out how it feels to have a prostate exam.
Chang got fingered. Like Freddie got fingered.
Yeah.
Chang.
Don't say it like that.
Freddie got fingered. It wasn't like Freddie got fingered.
Chang. In retrospect, do you regret your decision?
That was poor.
That's a good joke there.
Chang.
Jesus
Christ.
The thing about
you're
today,
laughing like you've got a finger up your bum again.
So when we set it up, we asked yesterday, because we're a shitty radio show, we asked yesterday if there's a doctor who would come and do it for free for us. We didn't get a doctor. We got a third year medical student who's actually a trained physio.
Never done it on a human being.
No. And he said to us on the phone, he said, can you guys please make sure that you've got some lube and gloves? So we had to go out and get it. And when I got to work today, Chang said, I don't have enough money on my FPOS card. Can you come with me to pay for the lube? So Chang and I went to the chemist to buy the lubricant for his rectal exam.
Unbelievable.
I recorded it. Do you guys want to hear what happened?
Oh, heck yeah, mate.
This is our little trip to the chemist.
We're at the chemist. We're going to get Chang some lube.
We're looking for some lube. You know, those ones are used for sex. Is it okay?
I thought you meant that one.
No, yeah. Okay. But is there a specific one for prostate exam ones? That, like, is that the only ones you have?
Oh, I'll ask if they've got anything else.
Is there a certain flavour that you'd like?
No. Does it matter? No one's going to be eating it.
Are you going to use the rest of it, or are you going to throw it out afterwards?
We'll see how much it costs first.
Go for your standard KY. It's a play one. That'll last 3 times longer, so we could...
What's a silicone intimate...
Depends how long you want your prostate exam to last.
I don't want it to last too long.
This will be 3 times longer. Can you just get the basic KY and we'll get the hell out of here?
Should we?
You look like my boyfriend.
It's $20.
It's company money, mate.
Okay.
Charge it to Leon.
So we'll get that. It says ideal use with condoms, but we're not using condoms.
No, we're using rubber gloves, same thing. The small one. Oh, you want a lot, eh? Just in case.
Yeah, we need shit loads.
You don't want to dry out.
Yeah, that would be fine. Yeah. Sweet.
It does the same job, though.
You'll be safe, mate.
Here you go, guys. Have a good day.
Cool, thank you.
She told us to have a good day. She thought we were going home to have sex.
Are we not going home to have sex?
No.
Alright, Chang. Off for some sex. Let's go.
So at the end of it, how much lube did they end up using? Have you got a bit left?
They've got a ton loads left, in case we need to do another prostate exam, we can use this.
Mm.
You should just take it home, mate.
No, I'm good.
Okay. Well, enough about Chang's ass and his weird lube. Here is today's podcast.
Guy, Sharyn, and Clint on the Edge.
If you go on our Facebook page, you'll notice there is some videos that we put up sometimes, and they're a little bit crazy. They're our dance of the days, where we just get our favourite song of that day, and we do ridiculous dance moves, usually including Guy doing a lot of pelvic thrusting.
Some people say my dancing is quite sexual, but I think it comes from a spiritual place. It's an emotional thing from the heart.
It definitely comes from a place, that's for sure. But we
you're quite an erotic dancer.
I think so. Well, that's what the ladies say when they see it, mate.
But now that we've got a show budget, and yesterday we used, you know, the February budget on our shark bus speed dating experience, we're now in April, and we thought, let's take our Dance of the Day videos to the next level and do an actual music video, a proper full-blown music video for Dance of the Day.
Yeah.
That's a really good idea.
We're hoping to shoot this video in the next 24 hours, so it'll be something we cut together quite fast and actually launch it tomorrow. But we need to choose a song to dance to.
Because we are all fighting about what song we do. I really want to do Drunk in Love by Beyoncé.
I really want to do Usher Burn.
I want to do... that one that goes, who let the dogs out? who let the dog? Or Aaliyah. It's been a long time. Shouldn't have left you without dog beat to stab two.
Stab two.
We can't do that song.
Or Hanson Umbop.
Because we can't.
Or Wigs.
Too many ideas, not enough dancing moves.
Exactly. Because we can't agree on what song that we choose, we need you to help us. So call us 0800 The Edge or text us to 3343. What should our debut full-blown music video dance be to?
We should do it to "We Like to Move It, Move It." We like to. Oh, there's not many
move
lyrics
it.
In there.
Yeah,
it's a song about how we like to move it.
Or we could do like an Edge type song, do something like Katy Perry.
Mm-hmm.
We could do a new song, Birthday. And we've had some come through on the text machine already.
Text machine is blowing up. You tried to say it to make me stop saying it.
I tried to make you not say that.
Good idea. Vinger Boys, We Like to Party. That is a classic.
Oh, we like to party. We like to party.
I'd prefer that one. We're going to Ibiza. Whoa.
Or the other one, Sha-la-la-la, and they do it in all the
Vinger
cowboy
Boys thing. Was such a classic band, eh?
Sha-la-la-la. Then they got ruined when Mike Peru slept with the cowboy.
Whee! Did he? That's amazing. They were so good. I wish I slept with the cowboy. Those guys are awesome. Someone suggested my 7-year-old son just said use all the songs and just mash them all up into one.
Oh yeah, a mega mix.
Someone said guys should do T-Pain's I'm in Love with a Stripper. I genuinely quite like that song as well. And someone said, instead of Stacey's mum, it can be Sharon's mum has got it going on.
Oh.
Mary Ellen does have it going on. That's a pretty good idea. Chrissy, what do you think we should do for our Dance of the Day music video premiere?
Well, my daughter and I were coming home from school and she screamed out that you guys have to do Savage's Swing.
Sharon,
well, it's basically, you know, Miley stole twerking off Savage.
Yes.
You listen to the words, it's so twerking.
How old?
That is true.
How old is the kid who had this hip swinging idea?
My daughter is 9.
She's 9.
She's got too much access to YouTube.
Yeah.
Thank you, Chrissy.
That or awesome. Chrissy's making her hips swing at home. Tracy, what's your idea?
Tracy. No,
Tracy, I can hear you.
See you later, Trace Dog.
Paul, what is your idea?
Yeah, I want you guys to do a twist on Benny Benassi's Satisfaction, and I want to see Guy in an apron and a mankini with an egg beater.
Yeah.
I want to see Clint with a rolling pin or a vacuum.
Oh, yeah.
Mankini as well.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. What have I got?
Well, you're going to have to play the opposite, so you're just going to be in a librarian suit or something.
Oh, yeah. That's nice.
You sound disappointed about that, Paul.
Well, no, the song on itself is a bit of a cliche. So
yeah, hey, Paul, I like that.
We've got to flip it.
When you called in with this idea, I was thinking you were going to go for the one, get Shaz Dog in a bikini. He reversed that stereotype, and Shaz Dog still asked for it anyway. She feels like she's a bit left out.
No, well, he sounded slightly disappointed about it.
That was his idea. He's a
Look,
nice guy.
Hey, I've just always wanted to have some sweet cleave in a music video. Stop trying to ruin my idea. God, great suggestion, Paul.
Sorry for not sexually objectifying you, Shaz Dog.
Raquel, what song do you think we should do for our first ever music video?
That one with the guys where they wear their clothes backwards and stuff. But, you know, jump. Crisscross
to make a
jump.
Daddy Mac will make a
jump.
That's, that could actually be quite cool. Will we have to wear, like, tracksuits and stuff like that?
I reckon that's a prerequisite.
The compulsory tracksuits.
Matching Adidas tracksuits.
That could be quite cool, actually. That's a good suggestion. Thank you so much, Raquel.
All good.
All right, the list is compiled. The studio is booked. The camera crew is ready. And overnight, we will shoot our first ever high-budget music video for our Dance of the Day video. And we'll post it online tomorrow.
Guy, Sharon, and Clint on the Edge.
We were called into a big, important group-wide Edge radio station Farnell meeting today, and it was a little bit stressful because you don't know what's going to happen.
Mm. Was it more stressful for you because you were late and you missed what the announcement was?
Yeah, that was quite stressful, I'm going to be honest with you, not being there on time.
Going into this, everyone was freaking out because we thought we were going to be told that we were being made redundant. We thought that our boss was leaving.
Yeah.
It was a horrible feeling.
The big bosses were there. They had the CEOs come to the meeting. For a minute there, I thought they were going to announce that Titanium were breaking up.
Thank God.
That was not the situation.
You only thought that because there was champagne ready to go. Just kidding.
I thought it was that the Edge drink bottle you might have heard advertised was taking off, which it is. It is taking off. 30,000 units sold, apparently.
Oh, yeah.
We sold 30,000 drink bottles.
Well, that's what people are claiming. I'm suspicious.
People are thirsty, and we gave a lot of those away.
I love the ads. Do you like drinking liquids but don't have a vessel to hold any them in? Then buy an Edge drink bottle, because it makes a lot of sense.
That wasn't the news, though.
No, it definitely was not the news. Who gets to tell everyone what the news is? Joey, we're going to paper, scissors, rock.
Okay,
this is
here we
important.
Go. Three-way paper, scissors, rock.
No, wait. Guy, you're out because you'll stuff it up. Okay, Clint and I.
Okay.
One,
paper, scissors. Is it show on three?
Yeah.
One, two, show or one, two, three, show?
Just whatever. Let's go.
So one, two, show.
One, two, three. Show. Oh, God.
One, two, three. Show. Yes, it's me.
Damn it. Unfair. All right, Clint gets through the news. Can we get a drum roll in the studio, please?
And we've got a studio audience because everyone's very excited about this. The Edge is getting a TV channel. Woo! In the next couple of months, The Edge will launch Edge TV.
This is going to be amazing. Basically, everything you love about The Edge that you already get, you're going to get that on TV as well. And you can get it on your app. You can get it on 3 Now. You can get it on TV. It's going to be awesome.
Is it going to have ads for the official Edge drink bottle?
Well, probably, mate. We're going to make an infomercial for it because we've got a very talented TV shopping channel host working for us.
I feel like we haven't thought this through. We've got a lot of work to do. We're going to have to go get some cameras and stuff.
Yeah, we have to get some cameras.
Get some makeup.
Get a
suit and tie like Hillary and Mike have on 3 News.
Just dust some Thin Lizzy on.
There's going to be a lot of work, guys, but it's very exciting news. Music videos are back.
Yeah, that's one of the big things. You'll be able to see music videos on TV again in an exciting way, and cool music videos, new music videos, all those videos of stuff that we do here at The Edge, which means Chang's prostate exam not just be a radio experience this afternoon. Soon it'll be a television experience.
There's going to have to be like an R18 adults only section.
Yeah, I'm not making this up. I already saw JJ making a prop for a TV show called JJ's Tits, and it's just going to be a half an hour of JJ's boobs. It's like when Nikki Watson used to host that show in lingerie. It's just going to be JJ and her boobs.
It's like Naked News, but heaps grosser.
Whoa.
Yeah.
Mean.
Oh, sorry. Is that not the consensus?
Finally, the medium for me to release my sex tape, guys. This is very exciting news for everyone. One more time, guys. Give it up for The Edge TV.
Hopefully you're excited about it. Information is going up on The Edge website, The Edge Facebook page, our Twitter account, all of that, so you can check out some more of it. But this is a little teaser for you.
On air.
Wow!
I love it. Online. And soon, The Edge is on TV. The Edge TV. Coming soon.
One of my favourite things about Tinder is that people are now taking it. I should. That's a weird sentence to start with.
Yeah, what are your favourite things about Tinder?
Of all the many wonderful things about Tinder.
I didn't know that you were on Tinder.
I'm not on Tinder, although there is someone pretending to be me, and if you do find them, punch them in the face for me, please, because that's not me. Anyway, one of my favourite... No, seriously.
Well, to find them, they'd have to go on a date with them, and they'd have to tee up a date and arrive at the date. And
that's what I'm saying.
Pretend to be interested in the date.
Yeah. Don't think that much of yourself, he's not getting dates.
Good
no
point.
No one's swiping left on that guy.
Good, very good point. Who, as if I get a lot of action, as if I'm a good person to try and pass this out.
Tell this guy to stop cutting my lunch.
If someone wants their hand held and to have their face talked off for 40 minutes, then maybe they'll swipe left, but they're probably not going to.
It's like you should use Dan Carter or something like that, though, eh? Like, use someone who actually pulls the ladies. Use a Sonny Bill Williams profile or something like that.
Yeah.
So, of the three... how old am I? 26. Of the three ladies who have been mildly interested in me in my 26 years, they will be taking one of them now because they're cutting my lunch. Now, what I love about Tinder is that people are now having a lot of fun with it, and it's kind of a new thing to screw with people. If you're on Tinder, to just like kind of take the piss out of it a little bit. And there's this guy called Tinder Dave, and he goes on there and basically just strikes up the weirdest conversations with you. Definitely Google search it if you want to check it out, because they're pretty funny. One of the ones he did recently is the first message he sends to this lady called Kendi is, "Marry one, kill one, screw one. Me, Hitler, me again." And the person wrote back, "Ha ha ha, I feel like the answer is quite obvious." And he wrote back, "Well, you could be a Nazi for all I know."
Oh, Dave.
And another awesome one is from Tinder Dave. You've got to look him up. Is with Laura. And she's run this long, long, boring conversation about how much she loves The Hunger Games. And he writes back, "Yeah, that's great and all. But sorry, I know this is kind of off topic, but what would you do if you just need to dispose a body?" And the person's like, and he's like, "Answer quickly." And she's like, you're weirding me out now. Bye. It's such a good thing. Here's one more. One more from Tinder Dave. You got to check this guy out. 20 questions. You first. And the lady's like, And he's like, and she's like, favorite type of cuisine? Easy one to start. And he writes Greek. And then he's like, all right, my turn. Have you ever done butt stuff? And she writes, haha, no, I haven't. And she writes, what's your number one fantasy? And he writes, butt stuff.
Oh, God.
I don't even know what that is.
That is enough from Tinder Dave.
If you want to see some butt stuff, though, later on in the show, we're going to have Chang.
How does it feel? Yeah.
Doing How Does It Feel? He is going to be receiving an on-air, what's it even called?
Prostate exam.
A prostate exam from an amateur. So that'll be coming up later in the show.
That's at 5 o'clock.
Guy, Sharyn and Clint. On the edge.
Let's get into the love shack together. If you've got a love problem that you need help with, then call us now, 0800 The Edge, or text us to 3343.
Can I hit you with a speedy one that's come through already?
Yes.
Studio, I'm in love with a Romanian webcam girl. Is online sex considered cheating?
If you're having online sex, I would say that was cheating.
Definitely.
But she's in Romania. Area codes, bro.
It doesn't matter. It's even weirder because you're probably paying for it. We're going to start off with a few from the text machine, aren't we?
From the text machine. Shaz Dog, been going out with a guy for 4 years. And when I really needed his support today, he told me to harden up or F off and tell someone who cares.
Wow.
Advice?
Well, if he didn't, I don't know if he had something else going on that was bothering him and he would just handle the situation badly, but if that is the way he treats you all the time, that's definitely not somebody I would want to be in a relationship with, because he needs to be there for you, good times and bad.
It could just be a one-off thing. I reckon they should tell your partner that you're hurt.
Yeah, definitely talk about it, and if that's what he actually meant and he just doesn't want to be there for you, then cut it.
Yeah, maybe he just had a bad sleep last night.
Maybe. Sometimes boys are like that. Same with girls.
Here's one that I think is quite interesting and maybe applied to me a couple of years ago. Shaz Dog, I'm in love with a 22-year-old girl and I am 17. Is that bad? And I don't know how to tell her I love her. Please help.
I don't think it's bad to be in love with somebody that's older than you or anything like that.
I've actually been in this situation before, but it was when I was like 21 and the girl was like late 20s.
Mm-hmm.
And so she was an older stripper.
Yeah, but no. No, she was not a stripper, thank you very much. Anyway, the problem is, in this situation, is that she might just be being friendly to you. She probably doesn't see you as a romantic option at all. Mm-hmm. So definitely don't start with, I love you. But you might want to try and ease into a relationship somehow without coming out too strong in case you get rejected.
Definitely. Next question.
Okay.
Oh, did I answer that one myself?
You just answered the question for me.
This one that we've got here on the phone is an interesting one. Do you remember a while back we got a call from a guy called Ant?
Oh my God.
Yeah.
Is that Ant?
That Ant. This Ant here. You might remember if you've been listening to the show for a little while.
My mum sort of contacted me and asked me if she would like to have a threesome with me and my girlfriend.
Oh, my
Aunt.
God.
My missus actually, she wanted to go for it. What? And now they're together and I'm by myself.
What? Hang on, Aunt. Okay, so your mum asked you.
We didn't know this before.
And your girlfriend to the threesome, and then you weren't keen to do that with your mum. So your girlfriend.
Hell no.
So your girlfriend.
No, good. Thank God, Aunt.
So your
thank
girlfriend
God.
Broke up with you, and now your girlfriend's going out with your mum.
Yeah.
Oh my god, my mind is exploding.
Okay.
So there we go. We are back with Ant. That was his situation last time. Welcome back to the show, Ant. What's the situation this time?
I don't know what happened between those two, but I'm not going to say her name, but she wants to get back with me.
Oh God, Ant.
Ant, let's just break this down simply, okay, babe? She left you for your mum.
That's what.
You're not going to have a pleasant Christmas ever. If every Christmas you're going around to your mum's house and you're wondering if they're going to go and get it on while you're opening your presents. So I would say on to the next one. And you don't want to be with someone that left you for a parent.
Yeah, well, I think I'm going to take your advice, Sharyn.
And can I just say that if you're ever in a romantic competition with your mum, chances are you want to get out of there as fast as possible.
The best advice is forfeit.
Totally.
Yeah, you crack me up.
And imagine if you guys were like kissing or something and she was like, oh man, you and your mum kiss the same. It'd be so weird. And so just get away from her, okay? And just find somebody else, because you're an amazing man, so you don't need her.
Good luck, Ant.
Yeah.
She's the actual definition of an MF.
Oh my gosh, she is too. She's the mother effer.
Yeah.
All right. Hey, thanks for calling in, Ann. Glad to hear that you're still kicking around, mate, and not going to go back to that girlfriend of yours.
Good. You better not.
Jeepers.
We have got Jessica on the line.
Jessica's
not
there.
Gone. What was Jessica's question?
Jessica's question, and I thought this was an interesting one. She said, my boyfriend is going overseas for 6 months and wants to go on a break until he gets back rather than us do long distance.
Classic. Dodgy.
Well, there are two sides to this coin. He could be doing the whole, oh, I just want to go and like have one last hurrah and come back and be with you. But the more likely situation is he just wants to have 6 months to go and get amongst as much international action as he wants to and then come back to you.
Maybe.
So you have to decide what you're comfortable with.
Or is he just being mature about it, perhaps, and going, hey, I'm going overseas. I don't want to do anything to upset you. So maybe we should just break up.
But if you actually cared about the person, then the temptation wouldn't matter. I've travelled all through Europe with a husband. I've still had a good time without having to get amongst.
So what's the advice? Is the advice...
I think the advice
force
is...
force him to stay with you?
No. The advice is whatever you're comfortable with. This is something you have to come up with personally. If it was me, I'd be saying see you later. Because, for example, Clint, you're extremely in love with your girlfriend.
Yes.
If you were going overseas,
thank you for pointing that out.
If you were going overseas for 6 months, would you break up with her?
No.
Why?
Because I don't want to. I don't want to go and see anyone else.
And because you love her.
Yeah, that's basically what I said. What?
Exactly. So if he actually loved you, it wouldn't be an issue. He would stay with you.
How great is it that the dude is assuming that he's going to go over to Europe and just meet all these Swedish babes? Chances are he'll break up with this great girlfriend that he's got, go overseas,
get fat,
get sleep with no one, come back and have nothing and ruin his life. That's my theorem.
I think she should just let him go and go and find someone that treats her the way she should be treated.
Here's a good one from the text machine. I live in Rotorua and I can't find a decent man and Tinder is not working. Are there any decent guys left?
This is something that I get asked all the time, especially from friends and stuff too, that, you know, really want to meet someone and they're struggling. I reckon, and it's the classic saying, the harder you look for it, the harder it is to find. And it's always the people you least expect that are the people that are actually a really good match for you. So if you actually kind of relax and stop looking for it so much that it consumes you, you'll actually find a really amazing person.
Can I also say, being from Rotorua, I've still got quite a large group of friends down there, single boys as well. There are good boys in Rotorua. Yeah. There's some really good men in Rotorua. They're just probably not at Lava Bar.
And also a lot of people have that like list in their head as well of what they want, and it puts so much pressure on the people that you meet. You just need to relax and stop putting so much pressure on someone you don't even know.
Guys, hot love tip, date a nerd. They're always available and they'll treat you really well. Just because they're a bit ugly, let it go. Data nerds.
And man, they've got good Wi-Fi at their house. That is Shaz Dog's Love Shack. Hopefully we've helped you out with something.
Guy, Sharyn and Clint.
On the Edge.
Last night we fell in love on a shark bus place.
We did that. We jumped on a bus that looked like a shark. Nobody really knew what to expect.
We didn't know what to expect and we organised it. It wasn't well thought through. It turned out to be a smashing success. Some would say too good a success.
Some would say we should rename the shark bus to the sex bus. We made a whole lot of love connections.
We basically organised like some sort of weird swingers party, eh? That's basically what we put together.
That's pretty much what it was.
Everybody was nervous, and Chang was playing host here at the Edge before we left. He provided a lot of Lindau, so the bus was well lubricated, would you say?
Every single person that came on the Shark Bus speed dating experience, apart from the people in relationships that work for the Edge, ended up getting at least a pash.
Chang get a pash?
Chang didn't get a pash. He was trying to impress one of the girls that worked at Britomart Country Club. So he just he just kissed girls on the side of their face.
I was impressed by Chang. He was an officer and a gentleman, but not everyone else was. Check this out. This is the start of the Shark Bus, and this is when it was all good.
We're about to start the speed dating. Before we get on the road, can I get everyone to join in our theme song of the Shark Bus speed dating tonight? We found love in the Shark Bus place.
We found love in the Shark Bus place.
May the speed dating commence in 5,
4, 3, 2, 1.
One love.
Now I get it. That's why the bus driver hated us. Was that? He hated us.
Sharyn, just to, if you can't, I'm going to paint the picture a little bit. Sharyn just pushed the bus driver out of the way, grabs the mic, the crappy little bus mic,
the headset microphone,
and just starts blasting her Rihanna version of "We Fell in Love in a Shark Bus Place" right down the mic. It was pretty awesome. So anyway, we got into the dating.
Yeah,
it went okay.
You were thrust into the dating pool because we were actually short of men in the end. We had almost twice as many girls as boys. So
to be honest, I sabotaged some of the men so I could get in there.
All single men were called on.
Didn't you just?
This is what it sounded like when we overheard one of Guy Williams' dates.
Time to start dating. Emma, lovely to meet you. I'm Guy.
Nice to meet you too.
I'm a Virgo. I'm 27 years old. I like cats and touch rugby and videos of cool videos.
I'm Emma. I'm 20. I am a university student, but I like to have a bit of fun. So I like cats.
I
was like 20. You're old enough to be. I'm old enough to be your brother.
Is that the girl that you went on the date with that then started saying, "Tell me about"? Wanted to tell you about her ex-boyfriend.
Yeah,
there's quite
a few of those. Hey, that's a bad start to a date. Hey, when you start yarning about your ex.
Yes, and then even worse, the worst speed date was Chang, because I then caught him texting during his speed date.
The first date is happening at the back of the bus at the moment with Chang.
This is so awkward. Why are you interviewing me?
Chang, you were a ring-in because someone pulled out, but you are a single man.
Yes.
What is your date's name?
Good question. I can't.
Oh, my God, Chang, you don't even know
Anna,
her name.
Anna. Apparently, I got matched on Tinder with Anna.
You didn't get matched. You got nested.
What does that mean?
She means she skipped you.
Oh, she asked me. Yeah, bitch.
Do not call your date a bitch, Chang. It's a long 3 minutes.
Really hurts my feelings.
Chang had an interesting tactic.
He was terrible. He was doing the whole treat a man and keep him keen, but the thing is that they were never keen in the first place.
I thought Chang, it seemed like this weird thing that Chang had set up where there wasn't enough guys and they were all weirdly blonde. But Chang was actually not that sleazy on the bus. I was quite impressed by him. He's a gentleman.
That's because he was waiting for his crush at the next destination.
Next, we're going to call some of the speed daters.
Oh, God.
For a bit of a debrief to see how the rest of the night went.
It turned into a bit of a shambles, let's be honest.
We saw them leave 2x2.
We're going to talk to one that ended up sleeping in a corridor. Last night, the shark bus speed dating experience went down. It was pretty awesome. A whole lot of people found love in a shark bus place. Everyone but two people went home with someone, including someone in this room. Would anyone like to put their hands up that they left the bar with someone last night? Guy Williams, your hands in the air like you just don't care.
What you've just done there, Sharyn, is you've done a visual thing that no one can see.
Yeah, we're not on HTV yet, mate.
So what's happened, this is one of the, I don't know if other people have been in the situation before, but I met someone on the shark bus and we had a lovely time. We really struck up some nice conversation. When I was about to leave, she said, "I want to go too," and I offered to walk her home. Today, when I get to work, I'm getting like a standing ovation, dude slapping me on the ass, getting high fives and all that stuff as if I'm the king of the world. I was nothing but a lovely gentleman and I had a lovely evening.
Let's find out with your friend that you met last night.
Oh no, welcome, don't.
Anna, welcome to the show.
Hi.
How's it going?
Good, thanks.
Now, can you please explain to us, because once you got off the shark bus, were you one of the girls that Guy was holding hands with?
No, I don't believe I was.
Oh, yeah.
God, this makes me seem worse.
Hand-holding Slazer over here.
Who am I?
Anna, slutty hand.
What happened when you guys left the Britomart Country Club last night?
Just exactly what he said. He just was a gentleman and walked me home.
There it goes. Thank you. Justified.
You didn't get a cheeky pash or anything, Anna.
I didn't get a cheeky pash.
Oh, no.
Be honest, did you want one?
Oh, I don't know. Maybe.
Me and Anna could have a beautiful thing going on. You guys have torpedoed it because I'm a gentleman. You've ruined my chance with Anna now.
Anna, have we ruined guys' chances with you?
Not at all.
Woo! I'm back in. I'm back in the game.
Well, you guys have swapped numbers after the shark bus, right?
Yeah.
Well, great. You guys just text each other, fall in love. Remember, if you make a baby after a shark bus romance, it has to be named Guy, Sharyn or Clint.
I'm smiling and winking. This is a great day.
The other person from The Edge who was on the bus and one of our daters is Oscar. Kia ora, Oscar.
Hey, how are you?
You came to
work. I'm really nervous.
Well, every time I get dragged into the studio, it ends horribly.
Oh, because this is Oscar who booty called Sophie. Oscar came to work late today with a quarter pack from KFC.
Great. You nailed it, bro. High five.
So did you have a good night last night?
A long night?
Yeah.
It was good.
Who did you make best friends with on the shark bus?
Look, a lot of friendships were made.
Yeah.
We were best friends. We hung out for a bit.
We hung out for a bit.
Oscar, have you bloody forgotten her name already?
No, I don't forget names.
Did you make friends with one person more than anyone else?
Yeah.
Yeah?
He's gone absolutely bright red. Oscar.
You guys, stop trying to bring up me and Oscar's friendship.
Oscar, did you or did you not pass anyone on the shark bus last night?
I might have passed someone on the shark bus.
Connection and we'll take it.
Can I?
I will. I need to put my hand up for this, guys. I made Oscar pash somebody by using a magic wand. So if I take full responsibility for this love connection, and if they end up getting married and having a baby, it will be named Sharyn.
There's a video being cut together right now.
Oh, no.
Everything that happened on the shark bus. So you'll see Oscar, you'll see Guy, you'll see Chang, you'll see all the lovely ladies we had on the shark bus for the dates, and hopefully that'll go up tonight. We've got to move on. We've got to do scandal.
Let's move on from shark bus and let's never talk about it again. Last night I saw some things that cannot be unseen.
Guy, Sharyn and Clint.
On the bloody edge.
We have reached what someone has just texted to the text machine as a new low. As we do How Does It Feel This Week, where we're going to find out how it feels to get a prostate exam.
Do you know what though? Some may say scraping the barrel. I say good on you, Chang, because this is promoting men's health and it's very important that men go and get stuff like this done.
Hang on, I'm having second thoughts now after the position that I have to be in. And like,
no time for second thoughts, mate. We're doing it soon. How does it feel? But Chang's getting a prostate exam.
Can we not do it?
No, we're going to do it.
No, we're doing it. Good luck for the butt, mate.
It's time for the new segment that we do every Wednesday where we try and find out and experience how something feels. It's appropriately titled, How Does It Feel? Today, we are finding out how it is cold, how it feels to be cold inside the anus. Chang is receiving...
Can you not
say... Sorry I said that word. I apologise for that word. It's gross.
It is the proper term.
Chang is receiving a prostate exam, as recommended by the listeners, and he lost the wheel. The wheel was spun, and Chang was decided he was going to do it. Can I just say, before we kick off the conversation, that while we're doing this, we have some viewers in the studio. Steph is here, eating some chocolate cake.
Steph,
how disgusting. What is wrong with you?
It's a really delicious, moist cake.
I've got to check out the prostate exam while I'm here, feeling a little bit peckish.
This is not a spectator sport. Steph, although we do have good camera crew and we do have a webcam.
Yeah, so, Steph, if you just want to see me naked, just say it.
She doesn't want to see you naked, mate. She just wants to see you get probed.
So, Chang, you're about 5 minutes away from getting a prostate exam.
Yeah.
How are you feeling at the moment, mate?
I'm actually... Like, I was fine until the guy put on double gloves and stuff, and I'm like,
the guy,
really nervous.
The guy he's referring to is Sharyn. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the studio Sharyn. Now, you might have noticed that I haven't introduced him as Dr. Sharyn or anything like that. Sharyn is a third-year medical school student. Sharyn, welcome to the studio, mate.
Thank you very much.
Thank you so much for doing this. Now, what's amazing about this situation, Sharyn, I've heard a rumour that you have never actually done a prostate exam on a human before.
Yeah, not on a live breather.
Sharyn's first time.
Have you done it on a dead person? Is that what you're going to say?
No, just on mannequins.
So, Sharyn, essentially, this afternoon we'll be finding out how it feels to receive a prostate exam and how it feels to give one as well.
Absolutely right.
Right. So, do you know what you're looking for?
I'm not going to be seeing. I'm just going to be feeling.
No, I mean, what you...
When Sharyn said that, he was like, I'm going to be feeling it. He just held up his finger and gave a little point, like, you know it.
Okay, this is a gross question, but this is about finding out how it feels.
Needs to be asked.
And I don't mean this to sound gross. How many fingers?
Just one.
Just the one?
Just one.
Okay.
Just the index.
And is there any preparatory work that Chang should be doing beforehand?
Well, I kind of asked him if he'd taken a dump today.
Yes.
And he said no, so it's going to be a bit...
There was something that I was worried about. Like, is there a risk that he could maybe, like, fart?
Oh.
Don't look at me. I don't know.
Is stuff coming out?
I doubt it. Oh, no. Not really.
No.
Okay, good.
So when you done it, I want to know, when you done it on the mannequin, what really happened?
We just got the technique right.
Oh, okay.
So he's never done this, Chang. He doesn't know. It could go terribly wrong.
We've got someone on the phone right now. Grant, how can we be of service of you tonight?
Well, basically, we're having our dinner here at the moment, and we're just you guys.
Oh, no.
Sorry about that, Grant, mate.
I don't know what to do about that, Grant, because it is really great because we're making people aware of men's health issues, but maybe just hold your dinner for about 10 minutes.
Maybe we shouldn't do this.
No, we're going to do it.
We're doing it.
No, we can't.
Grant, just quickly, have you had a prostate exam before yourself?
I myself haven't, and I'm not sure. I'll be listening with interest to see how it goes.
Yeah, well, that's the idea.
My little boy just says hello, quickly.
Hi.
This is weird.
Hey, what, Grant, before you go, what's for dinner, mate?
We don't know what's for dinner. All right.
Thanks,
next.
Grant. I hope you're having mashed potatoes.
The KY jelly is ready. The rubber gloves are ready. When we come back, Chang is going to experience how a prostate exam feels.
Can you give me 10 minutes? I go to the toilet.
No, no time.
You've got two songs, Chang.
Good luck, mate.
Do what you need to do.
Like, go home?
This is a shocker.
I walked behind him before. He's nervous farting, so that's not a good sign.
Can I just say, Chang, you are a New Zealand hero. For those of us who just joined us, I was dancing and smashed a light. Chang is about to experience how it feels to receive a prostate exam.
So currently I'm in a lab coat with wearing nothing underneath. I feel so naked at the moment.
I just saw a little bit of testicle. It was lovely. All right.
I feel really uncomfortable because I watched you practicing the position and I was just like, I can't be here.
Hang on. How do you think I feel?
I don't know. I guess Ashan's going to find out.
That is what the segment's all about, Chang. How are you feeling?
I'm feeling like really, really bad and nervous that something horribly could go wrong.
Before we start this, can we all just pause for a second and take a minute to acknowledge how seriously weird this is?
And we've got Oscar on the phone right now. Oscar, you've got some advice for Chang.
Yep, first thing, I just want to say, good luck, Chang. It's going to be great.
How do you... Hang on. How do you know this?
Well, I don't know it for personal experience at all, and I never hope I do. But one of my mates who lives up in Wellington, Hamilton, got this done to him because he feared he had prostate cancer, and he came out of it finding out he didn't have prostate cancer, but he didn't necessarily like having a finger up his bum.
No, not necessarily.
Awkward would it be if we found something up there?
Yeah, true.
Well, at least we would know, and we could get onto it ASAP.
Yeah.
Kristen, you're a doctor. Have you got a warning for Chang?
Yeah, I just hope this guy's got small fingers, because if he doesn't do it right, he might be bleeding out of your ass for a week.
he did tell us that he cut his nails. Is that a good thing?
It is a good thing, but generally men have much larger hands than women. You should have got a female and it would have been a lot nicer.
Hang on. Kristen, where are you at the moment?
I'm just driving home from work. I'm in the cargo. Oh,
turn around, mate. You're driving up to Auckland. We need your help.
Hang on. Can we have her on the phone just in case things go horribly wrong?
No, she'll be right. Kirsten's got to get home. Thanks for your call, Kristen. Let's get this done, I reckon. I need to just have this over.
This is Ashan's first time. What could possibly go wrong? Let's do this, guys. Chang, get down on the table.
And you never know, Chang. You could end up being one of those people that enjoy it.
Okay. Ooh, okay. I'm going to lie down on the thing. I feel really uncomfortable because I'm like completely naked here.
I can't.
That is so awkward.
Ashan?
Hang on.
It might be a bit cold, Chang.
What do you mean it might be a bit cold?
The KY jelly is a bit cold.
Really?
Yeah.
Is KY jelly what doctors should be using?
Is it over yet?
Maybe not in the actual office, but who knows?
Oh, so you don't really use KY jelly?
Any sort of lube works.
But this is we're not having sex here, you remember that?
Just relax, Chang.
Do I not look relaxed? Oh, God.
Pull your knees towards you.
Okay, pull my knees towards you. Okay, right, hang on. Let me just prepare myself. Dude, don't rush me.
Is it not in yet?
We're still preparing.
Okay. Wait. Let me just breathe in first. Hang on.
I'll tell you when to breathe.
Okay, hang on.
Make sure you do a big cough, Chang.
What do I have to do? Do I have to cough?
No, don't cough.
Okay. Shit, just
cough. My finger's going to get stuck in
you clench and rip his finger off.
Okay. Okay, right. hang on, just let me stop laughing first.
This sounds like an awkward first time. Can you just get it in already?
Okay.
You gotta lie on your side proper.
Okay.
Pull your knees to it.
Relax, okay. Chang.
I am
relaxed. Just take a deep breath.
Okay.
It's gonna get cold.
Whoa. I feel the gel on my butt already.
Stop clenching.
Okay, stop
clenching.
Okay.
Right, ready? Okay. It's gonna be a bit cold.
Ow! Okay, that's really sore. Ow!
That's it.
Okay.
It's 5 seconds.
Ladies and gentlemen, that was it. Chang just received a prostate exam.
I think I just got bum braked.
Don't say that. I'd like to apologise for anyone who heard that. We are sorry. We are plumbing the depths here. We are plumbing the depths of Chang's anus. He just received a prostate exam, and by all accounts, it went very smoothly. Everyone is safe.
Oh, God.
Chang, how does it feel, mate?
That feels so uncomfortable.
Okay, so the rule of how does it feel, Chang Hung, you just had a prostate exam. How does it feel in one word?
Uncomfortable.
Just quickly. Sean, is Chang all good?
He's fine.
He's a healthy man?
Yeah, he is healthy.
Hey, there we go!
Hey!
That was the most awkward thing ever.
That was the funniest shit I've ever seen just in my life.
Just go to a real doctor, though.
Let's move on. I just want to go and cry in a corner now.
Also, just so you know, Ashan's not even training to be a doctor either.
No, he is.
Ashan, thank you so much.
Thank you so
Chang,
much.
Thank you so much. Another installment of How Does It Feel? Done and dusted.
Well, that was something,
wasn't
it,
guys? Why are you
guys
breathing in and out? I'm the one who feel violated here. I feel very, like, I felt like my cherry got popped.
Chang.
We'll put that down as a new low in New Zealand broadcasting.
Should we put it down as a low, though? Because if we move away from the humour of hearing Chang in a very compromising position, we were doing it for a real cause, because it's a thing that men in New Zealand have to go through and should go through, and we should raise awareness for it.
So if you miss what just happened, I had a prostate exam live here on the studio. So... And from a non-medical doctor.
And I'd just like to point out, it's not as scary as Chang is making it sound. He was getting it done in front of all of his workmates and by someone that wasn't actually a doctor. So that's why he was reacting a lot more than what you normally would.
But the general consensus is that it wasn't that bad, am I right, Chang? It wasn't too bad.
It's uncomfortable.
It's not great.
This is what it sounded like in the heat of the moment. This is the... This is how it went down.
Take a deep breath.
Okay.
It's going to get a bit cold.
Whoa. I feel the gel on my butt already.
Stop clenching.
Okay, stop clenching.
Okay. Right, ready? It's going to be a bit cold.
That's really sore. Ow.
That's it.
Okay.
It's 5 seconds.
All this has done is A, not made it impossible for me to look you in the eye, and B, made me imagine what you're like in the bedroom, and I just imagine you're going to be like, whoa.
Well, if someone sticks a finger there, then you probably would be like that.
Exactly, Sharyn. I just want to say, we have leftover KY jelly here, and I... Rubber glove. Boys?
No, thank you, Chang.
Amateur prostate exam.
Wow. You put your finger Hung up here. One, you put your finger up a guy's butt one time, he wants to start doing it to everybody else.
In seriousness, note, someone did text in saying you might put men off getting a prostate exam. It's a very short period of uncomfortableness for something pretty amazing, checking for prostate cancer.
Yes.
If you do have thoughts about your prostate, you can call the helpline on 0800 for prostate, 0800 477 678. If you want to get checked up, which every man should.
How are you feeling now, Chang? Got your pants back on?
Yeah, I feel comfortable now. I might have gone and tell Mum what happened, though.
Take the KY.
Jesus.
Guys, Sharyn and Clint. Itch.
Well, breaking news from the internet, guys. There's been rumours that the Sevens next year, the rugby tournament, may be made alcohol-free.
Dun, dun, dun.
How great is that? Isn't that why everyone goes to the Sevens? Is to get dressed up as something and girls can wear lingerie in public and they all get drunk together?
The police had like 100 incidents or something last year.
Yeah.
Or this year's one. So as a result, they're thinking of revoking the liquor license for the organisers. How good would that be? Everyone would realise that Sevens is actually a terrible joke sport, which is not fun to watch at all.
Aww, don't be mean.
People just go because they like wearing novelty costumes and getting drunk.
How stupid would you feel if you were just in the stadium, sober, dressed as Action Man, and you're standing there with your mates like, oh, this is a bit weird, eh?
Yeah. This isn't how I remembered it.
These chicks aren't as attractive as I thought they were last year.
It's taking out the one and only ingredient that makes that thing work.
In all honesty, if they took the booze away, and this is an indictment on Kiwis in general, if they took the booze away, attendance numbers would plummet.
Oh, totally. And it would just be another win for the Nines, which looks like it was more fun anyway.
Well, the Nines did look like a good time, actually.
Nines were good because people had their... I went there. I covered it for The Edge. The video's on theedge.co.nz. It had the drinking better planned out.
Yeah.
They limited the amount of alcohol people could have. So people could still go and have a good time.
Yeah.
But they weren't like the Sevens where people preload. It goes for like 8 hours, and 2 hours in, they're ready to like dive into a rubbish bin.
Also with the Nines, people actually know who the guys were on the field.
Every single person
playing is a big star.
Yeah. It will be a weird one and see if it happens. But I suppose if there's been that many incidents, they kind of have to take the alcohol license away. Like if you had a bar in town where 100 people every time they opened were being thrown in the cells and spewing all over the sidewalk, the bar wouldn't be allowed to serve booze anymore, would it?
How are all the bars in Hamilton still serving booze then?
It'll be an interesting one. We'll see how it plays out.
Sharyn and Clint
on the Edge.
That's the end of the podcast. Today's been a weird day, but I feel like it's been a good day.
It's been an amazing day.
It's been an exciting day with the launch of Edge TV coming soon as well.
Chang doesn't have prostate cancer.
Woohoo!
We shot a video of that, by the way, so that'll probably be the premier thing to be on Edge TV. What a way to start.
What, Chang's rectal exam?
It'll be a great opening episode.
No, it's not going to be that.
We'll be back tomorrow with another edition of the Guy, Sharyn and Clint podcast. And until then... sayonara.
Ka kite anō.
The Guy, Sharyn and Clint podcast.